cholesterol, water, electrolytes. And this bile is stored in the gallbladder. The fundus of the gallbladder can be seen on the lower part of the liver. Through cystic duct, it is entering in the gallbladder. Here, the bile is concentrated. When the food, especially the food which is rich in the fatty food, reaching in the small intestine, a hormone is secreted by the duodenal mucosa, the cholecystokinin. Cholecystokinin is secreted by mucosa of the duodenum, and this cholecystokinin is responsible for contraction of the gallbladder. And finally, bile is leaving the gallbladder and entering in the gut, that is the intestine, lumen of intestine. The bile salts in the bile are responsible for breakdown and emulsification of the fatty food. What is the role of these bile salts in the bile during ingestion of fatty food? These bile salts are responsible for breakdown and emulsification of the fatty food. The fatty food is coming in the lumen in a large particle form. The bile salts attach this large fatty globule, and finally it is broken in small pieces. This mechanism of bile salts breaking a large piece of the fat into small pieces is known as emulsification. And this is a mandatory process. This is mandatory for digestion of the fats. If fats are not broken down by the bile salts, the digestion and absorption of fats is almost impossible. To make it possible, there is emulsification of the fatty food into small particles by the bile salts. So this is the part of digestion and metabolism. Immunological. The other function of the liver is immunological activities. Involved in many types of the immunological and defense mechanisms of the body. The liver has to bear the toxins which are ingested with food, the alcohol, sometimes poisoning, taken by accidentally or also taken for voluntarily for some suicidal or homicidals. All these activities, all these types of the defense, the first player is the liver. In some cases it may also be kidney, but the first soldier which is facing all these types of toxins, the poisons, the alcohols and the drugs is the liver. So it is responsible for some protection and immunological activities. Some hematological activities also involved in hematopoiesis. So it is also a big function of the liver. Hematological activities. in embryonic period and in fetal period. Liver is involved in hematopoiesis, the formation of RBCs, formation of WBCs, formation of platelets. Remember always, the yolk sac is the first place. The yolk sac is the first place where the hematopoiesis starts. But RBCs, which are formed in the yolk sac, are nucleated. The RBCs which are formed in the yolk sac are having nucleus. The other sites which are also involved in the hematopoiesis during embryonic period is the liver, the spleen. These are also having or also play role of hematopoiesis, the formation of the blood and the blood cells. So main functions is the digestion, the metabolism, the immunological function and hematological function. So we have to remember only four or five functions. One more function is the storage of some nutrients. So I will consider these functions like the storage of the nutrients, like it is involved in the synthesis of glycogen from glucose. When we take food, it is having glucose, the carbohydrate, the fats and proteins. When the carbohydrates are reaching in the duodenum and ileum and jejunum, the main center of absorption is the jejunum. These are absorbed inside the bloodstream or capillaries in form of glucose. When this glucose is reaching to the liver through portal vein, the blood is receiving its blood supply from portal vein, which is forming 80% blood. The portal vein and the hepatic artery. Hepatic artery is contributing 20% blood, and the portal vein is contributing 80% blood to the liver. Now, why this 80% blood is reaching to liver through this portal vein? Because all nutrients which are absorbed in the GIT, either from the stomach, from the duodenum, jejunum, ileum or colon, all are reaching to the liver through portal vein. When glucose is entering in the hepatocytes, hepatocytes are converting this glucose in glycogen under influence of insulin, which is secreted by beta cells of the pancreas. So glucose is converting in condensed form the glycogen, and glycogen is the storage form of the glucose in animals, like starch in plants. So in animals, in all animals, animal world is having a storage form of glucose. This is main fuel of the cells in the body. So this fuel is stored in form of glycogen during starvation and fasting. This glycogen is converted in glucose and art is taken for production of the energy, the ATP. ATP is currency of energy. So glycogen is again converted in glucose and energy is utilized for all body activities. When we are resting, simply we say, I am in resting, but we are not in resting. Even in resting position, we are breathing in, breathing out. We are moving our hands, and even we are stabilizing our head on the trunk. So even this neck, when it is rotating the head, or when this is supporting the head, there is requirement of the ATP. For long fasting and starvation, glycogen is again converted in glucose and taken by the body cells for the production of ATP, the energy. Besides the glycogen, it is also a storage house for fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E and K, and B also vitamin B12. These all are stored in the liver. For vitamin A, vitamin D, vitamin E, and vitamin K, and B12. All vitamins are stored in the liver. Now, the anatomy of the liver, we will move on the topic. The anatomy of the liver. Liver is very important for body. It is vital for life. It is involved in many type of activities, and it is also performing some extraordinary activities also. So liver is made up of, anatomically it is made up of four lobes, broadly divided in two lobes, the right lobe and the left lobe. The liver develops in the ventral mesogastrium, so covered by the visceral peritoneum. Almost all liver is covered by visceral peritoneum except some parts. I will discuss in detail about these peritoneal relations and the anatomy of the liver, but simply it is covered by a capsule. Inside the peritoneum there is a capsule. This capsule is known as Gleason's capsules. Gleason's capsule. And outside the Gleason capsule there is peritoneum, the visceral peritoneum. The liver is divided in right and left lobe by the falciform or broad ligament. So this is the division of the right and left lobe. Besides right and left lobe, there is a caudate lobe and a quadrate lobe. After a short break, I will talk about the anatomical division and finally the functional divisions of the liver and relations of this superior surface, the visceral surface, the right surface, anterior surface, and the posterior surface. We will talk in detail after a short break.